meditations of our hearts and mind be acceptable to you, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen.
Now I can tell you one word. And with that one word, be done with this sermon. That one word, you can find the aspect of family, deep reading, and that's overall life in general. That one word is trust. If you can't have or don't have trust, what's the point of living? You can't carry your burdens without trust. You can't trust anyone with anything. By a show of hands, how many of us have or had secrets? Now, how many of us told people these secrets? And if that person told that secret, will you ever trust them again? No. Without trust, we can never get anywhere. Can't trust your family, how will you ever do anything? You don't trust man working bungee jump, will you ever go bungee jumping? I hope you all say no. How can life be worth it if you can't trust? So at church, what's the point of coming if you don't trust God? I'm very much. But we all have struggles. It's part of life. Okay, again, by show of hands, how many of you can say that Jesus is Lord? Right? I see everyone stand up because you're all here. I knew that, or you're dragged here. So, how many of you need it? Again, we want to mean it. Who needs it? Don't mean it like a woman comes with and it doesn't work out well. I tried it. Okay, so this is where faith becomes our part and not God. God can trust us, but God can't force us to trust him. It's a voluntary decision. So if we don't trust God, God will provide for you, but if you don't do that, it's not going to happen. So some of us are right now in a deep struggle, and we said that we do because we do, but there's conflict and it's just not working. But we won't tell anyone about that struggle because we don't trust anyone enough to share this big burden. It's like a, you ever seen that commercial where there's an elephant sitting on that person? Like, well, we kind of have like five elephants. And it's like, you're trying to walk, and you're like, ugh. And it doesn't work. Yet. So, this is where God steps back in. So, everyone thinks that God is that big, roaring lion that he seems like, bruh, I'm going to tell you what to do now. But that's not always going to happen. He's normally often that whisper that people call their conscience. Most of the time, still. Yeah. So, God's there, and he's like, hey, it's okay. Everything is going to be fine. Doesn't matter how bad you messed up. I'm pretty bad. But it's okay. It doesn't matter. I can show you multiple people that have messed up several times, and they try and come back, and they come back to me. But way too true. You can buy that person chocolate. They might like you as a friend. More chocolate for them. But there will always, always be that tiny piece that's not going to trust you. I also read this book recently, called Going Vintage. It's about this girl. She finds out that she can't trust her boyfriend. Uh-oh. I think we don't see where this is headed. So, she dumps him because she can't trust him. And so this whole plot of this whole book is swirling around trust and how social media kind of throws that whole trust thing off. And it's just part of life. I mean, everyone usually has some type of connection to social media, Instagram, Facebook, Kick, other social media that are not coming to my mind right now. But if you can't trust someone, there's usually never going to be any romantic relationship between these two people. It's not going to happen. You don't trust them. And so now we get into Mother's Day. So Mom, this is your day. You're the role model of your children, most of the time. I hope all the time, but usually not the case. So you are smart, strong, brave. Everything your child hopes to be when they grow up. But to make a great question, are you trustworthy? Because if you aren't trustworthy, then the whole smart, brave, and everything else disappear just like that. There's nothing there if you aren't trustworthy. We are built on trust. Our whole lives, all of our relationships are built on trust. If you can't trust yourself, or anyone, or anything around you, you might as well just lock yourself in your bedroom and cry. There's nothing that's going to change that you can't trust. And if you can't trust, I'm sure there are lots of people that you can talk to. If you remember nothing else from this sermon today, just remember that there will always be God, Jesus, and hopefully one other person that you can trust. That one person might be someone you know. Might be someone in China that you have no clue who they are. That person might be your mom. It might not be. The person that you can trust might be sitting right next to you. Again, that might not be the case. Even if there is no one else that you can trust, there is always God and Jesus. If God and Jesus aren't there, then look again, because you're either in a deep swirling vortex of nothing, or you're not looking. And I can tell you what not looking is, personally. That's my mom. I'm really good at not looking. There will always be God around. Look. I trust you. I promise I trust you. Yes, I do trust all of you, but I promise you He is there. He might even be right next to you in the eyes of the person sitting next to you. And you, and you, and you, and you, and I don't have enough fingers to point at all of you, so imagine pointing at all of you. And he